Emmett was sitting in his car when two men approached and pulled a gun on him. Emmett fought with them and ran. The gunman
shot him in the back.
A passerby later saw Emmett and called 911. But by the time he arrived at the hospital,
Emmett had died.
Andre Emmett, born August 27, 1982, died September 23, 2019. Today's feature is up there as one of the best college players of the early 2000s for me. He's the epitome of what a coach would want from a recruit entering their program. He was productive early, but not instantly, a great leader and would-be face of the team, and stayed eligible, which having your star player do consistently can be harder than you think. He also fulfilled all the plans everyone involved had for him in his time as a college athlete by helping Texas Tech pick themselves up off the mat as one of the worst programs in the country before he and a year later Bobby Knight got there. He graduated, which I'm sure his parents were proud of, and he became an NBA draft pick, dreams I'm sure he's had for himself since a young child. You can't ask for too much more from a collegiate athlete. Like most college prospects, though, their growth stunts usually show themselves when it's time to change levels and the expectations begin to set in. The business side of things begin to create politics and circumstance, and most importantly, money is now involved, which creates its own effects on a player and how well the team does. Today, we'll talk about three reasons Andre Emmett did not see the same success in the NBA he did in college, causing him to only play a total of 14 games on the big stage after being first-team All-Conference three straight years and a consensus first-team All-American just before leaving for the league. If there was anyone you'd choose to have immediate success on the pro level, it was Andre Emmett. Size, four-year maturity, a star on his team for three of them, so knew what that pressure felt like, played for one of the best defensive coaches or coaches period in Bobby Knight, and put up high-level numbers years in a row. Becoming a washout in the league was not supposed to happen to this guy. Another thing that was not supposed to happen to Emmett, who by all accounts was a model citizen and family man, was being a victim of gun violence, all for the possessions of the things he worked hard to acquire. Let's talk about it. Rest in peace to Andre Emmett. Andre Emmett was a 6'5 shooting guard small forward from Dallas, Texas that averaged 20 points and 10 rebounds as a senior for Dallas Carter High School and didn't have many schools after his services outside of hometown Texas Tech. He was ranked outside the top 100, but that all changed at Tech, where he became one of the best players ever for the school. Stunt number one, not leaving school earlier. When it comes to making the decision to stay or leave school early as an NBA prospect, I'm pro situation. Meaning I'm not against a player realizing he's either not ready or his stock isn't high enough and returns to school. On the other hand, I think it's imperative a player or whoever is guiding him to also realize the window of opportunity he may be passing up by staying too long. In the case of Andre Emmett, I think he stayed a bit too long and it cost him in the end. Entering Texas Tech under James Dickey for his freshman year, Emmett did not see the success of a player you'd think would one day become an NBA draft pick. Because he was still a bit raw leaving high school, it was expected he'd struggle in his first season or maybe even longer. As a freshman, he averaged just 7.7 points and 3.6 rebounds per game, more turnovers than assists, and struggled shooting the ball from all areas on the court. That, of course, changed in his sophomore season, with Bobby Knight taking over as head coach after a well-publicized coaching career at Indiana. Knight immediately showed that Emmett was a victim of not being used correctly when he turned his level of production into an All-American performer and future NBA prospect. He averaged almost 19 points and 7 rebounds as a sophomore, along with showing he could improve as a free throw and three-point shooter. He led the Raiders to the NCAA tournament in Knight's first year and first for the team in 5 straight seasons under Coach Dickey. Could he have left after that year? Of course. The amount of publicity it brought to have Coach Knight be successful again after everything he went through was enough to keep his name hot all throughout the draft process, with everyone in the media wanting to hear the coach speak about his team leader that helped them get to the tournament, losing only 9 games. As a prospect with his size and two-way ability, I'm sure he would have went in the first round, not to mention the extra juice of potential freshmen and sophomores have should they leave in those years. He decided to return for a junior season that set up him having no choice but to come back for a senior campaign due to the Raiders missing the tournament in his junior season and questions being raised about said potential and shooting. Stunt number 2, just missed a deal. The first round contract that would have in itself changed how the outcome of Emmett's NBA career went. Another byproduct of him staying all 4 years in school when he could have left 2 years earlier was him being taken in the second round and missing out on guaranteed money had he been taken just 6 spots earlier. It's a weird politic the NBA game plays when it's draft time. Seniors are almost scoffed at as not having much potential to grow as underclassmen. As a senior in the draft, you have to have improved each year in college at least one area of concern. For Emmett, it was his shooting and making plays for others as a projected NBA shooting guard. As a three-point shooter, his averages showed inconsistency in results, and not only was he below average in that area, he didn't take much of them, which, as a shooting guard in the league with a deeper line and more aggressive defenses, this combination could scare off just enough teams that you fall just outside a guaranteed deal that could keep you around longer, giving you at least a chance to grow and turn around a slow start. He was taken with the 35th pick in the draft by the Seattle Supersonics and traded on draft night to the Memphis Grizzlies. As a second round pick coming in to fight for minutes and career longevity, it could be a tough transition for any player, especially a former college star, now a small fish in a big pond. Emmett found it hard to receive minutes on a Grizzly team. I didn't think he would have such struggles. But he did, averaging just 0.9 points in only 3 minutes a game behind Dante Jones, Shane Battier, and Bonzi Wells. Because he struggled shooting off the catch and off the dribble from 3, not being able to create for teammates, nor defend as the team expected, they did not re-sign him for a second season in Memphis, and he wound up traded to the Heat in 2005 and waived before playing a game for the team. A guy known to slow start could have used that first round contract and more time to develop. Stunt number 3, victim of circumstance. Andre Emmett not being re-signed or not picked up by another team until 2012 on a 10-day with the Nets where he played just 6 games did not mean Emmett was not a good player. In basketball, that's how it is sometimes. Opportunity can be hard to come by in the league where every day as you get older, you become expendable to the team that you're not performing well for. There can be a player here and a rookie there that the team is more invested in, where it doesn't matter if you're better than them or not. He spent most of his pro career in the NBA D League, CBA, and overseas, where in the D League he became a 2-time All-Star and showed he could shoot the ball at that level, which further clarified that him not getting the opportunity to do that in the NBA was all circumstance. He was the scoring champion for the CBA in 2010. Sadly, in 2019, he also became a victim of circumstance, being at the wrong place and wrong time when he was shot and killed during a robbery of his possessions. As he sat in his vehicle, he was approached and told not to move as the man attempted to steal his necklace. Emmett then took off running as the gunman opened fire and shot him dead. Three have been indicted for the crime that happened September 2019 and are awaiting trial. He was last a member of the Big Three League before that all happened. All in all, Andre Emmett was a star basketball player in college and I'm sure a star father to his two daughters that lost their dad at the ages they probably won't remember in the future. Another senseless killing of our own when we get so riled up about police brutality and other injustice against black people. For a chain and a watch? I hate to say this, but I have to. Guys, give it up, man. Just give it up. You have two young girls to get home to. It's not worth it. Thankfully, Texas Tech and others have set up foundations to help his children as they transition into life without their father. Much respect to the Emmett family. Once again, rest in peace, Andre Emmett.